In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create flickering text animation in DaVinci Resolve. Let's get to it. Here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and I'm going to start by creating a new Fusion composition by opening Fusion Workspace, then select the text plus icon. That should automatically create and connect the nodes for us, and to move the view, you can use middle mouse button. Now I'm going to select the text one node, then open the inspector panel to see the settings and type something. But before I do, I'm going to quickly set the font to be Poppins. Then left click any text box and type flicker in all caps. Then increase the size of the text to your liking. Then open the shading settings. And in the select element, you should see the numbers. Select the number 2. Then make sure it is enabled. That will add a stroke to the text. And by default, the color is set to red. So from here, we can change the color to white. Then I'm going to set thickness to 0.005, so we have a very thin stroke. Then let's go back to the text settings, right click in the text box and select follower. Then you should see the modifiers button up here, click on it. In the timing settings, let's set order to be random but 1 by 1 and delay to 4. Then go to the shading settings of the modifiers. And here we're going to create keyframes for opacity. So make sure the time indicator is at the start of the timeline at frame 0 and create a keyframe on opacity by clicking this diamond icon, then set opacity to 0, go 5 frames forward, and keep in mind that my timeline is set to 30 frames per second, so this might be a bit different for you. So go 5 frames forward, set opacity to 1, then go 5 frames forward again, set opacity to 0, 5 frames forward, opacity 1. Now in the select element, select the number 2, the one where we have stroke, and do the exact same thing. Go to the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for opacity, set it to 0, go 5 frames forward, set it to 1, 5 frames forward, 0, 5 frames forward, 1. Now open the keyframe settings, make sure text 1 is expanded so we can see the keyframes, then click zoom to fit icon to see the keyframes up close. So here we have the keyframes, and I'm going to duplicate them in order to extend the duration of the flicker. First, I'm going to move the time indicator to 20 frames, that will be 5 frames after the end keyframe that we have. Then drag and select the keyframes and they should turn yellow, that means they are selected. Then hold Ctrl key on the keyboard and left click and drag on any of the keyframes to duplicate them, then move them to the right. And you'll see that we've duplicated the keyframes. And if you want to further extend the duration of the animation, you can just keep duplicating the keyframes. In my case, I'll leave it as it is. I also want to create some variation between the text that has fill and the text that has outline. And for that, I'm going to offset the keyframes of the text that has fill on it. So this one, select opacity 1, so it's highlighted, and then move it slightly to frame 3. So the keyframes of this opacity 1 start from frame 3. Now, if you have a look, we should have some variation, but at the moment, you can see that the text is fading in and out. And if that's something you want, it is completely fine, but I prefer the letters to instantly appear and disappear and look like an actual flicker. For this, I'm going to close down the keyframes and open the spline editor. Then make sure text 1 is checked so we can see the keyframes. Again, click the zoom to fit icon to see the keyframes up close. Click somewhere in the empty space and press Ctrl A or Command A to select all of the keyframes. Then down here you have the presets, and I'm going to select the step out preset. And now if we take a look, the letters will no longer fade in and out, they will flicker. So let me better show you this. I'm going to disable checker underlay. And here we have just the flickering text. And here I'm going to make the animation better by adding glow effects. But first I'm going to close down this spline. And then I'm going to select the text one node, press Ctrl space on the keyboard to open the search bar. And here I'm going to type glow. And I'm going to select the glow, then click the add button. I'm going to keep the settings of the first glow as they are. Then I'm going to select the glow, press Ctrl C, Ctrl V to duplicate the glow. So for the glow number 2, I'm going to set glow size to 200 and blend to 0.1. Then I'm going to select the glow number 2, Ctrl C, Ctrl V again to duplicate it. For the glow number 3, I'm going to set glow size to 1000. So here we've added very nice glow, and if you want to add a background of some kind, it is super easy. So make sure you're not selecting any nodes, and then up here, select the background node. That'll create the background node, drag it over here. Then disconnect the glow that goes into the media out by double clicking on the arrow. Then drag the square from the last glow and connect it to the square of the background. That will create the merge node. And then connect the square of the merge node into the media out. Then select the background node. And here, choose any color you want. I'll do a very dark blue. Click OK. And here we have a background with all the glows applied. So let's go ahead and do a preview. So here is our complete flicker text animation created in DaVinci Resolve. Thank you guys for watching.